So, next one can be a solenoid valve. We just had this one before, and you know about the performance of this one, and I do not want to talk about it more. We've just talked about it enough before, previously. Okay, and let me just, you know, put some stars here, this one and this one. Both of them are totally optional, depends on your function and your performance of your work. It means that just the regulator is mandatory to have for case of air set, but these two things are totally optional, so please bear in your mind this item too. And the tubes that we have here, all these items are stainless tube. Let me just write it with red color. These are stainless steel 316 tube, and the size of it can be quarter of inches or half of inches. Both of them can be possible. Sometimes we can use 3/8 inches too. Okay, after that, we have the positioner that I want to talk about now. So this is the positioner, as you can see, something just like it. On some positioner, you are able to find out two pressure gauges, something just like it. Some of them actually are equipped with a display too. Okay, that's it. And there are some other maybe cursors or buttons or things like that on too. As you know that, there must be a control signal from control room, from control, central control room, and as you know that it's 4 to 20 milliampere. It sends to the positioner, and after that, the outlet tube is going to be connected to the actuator. Okay, something just like it. We have the actuator here, for example. And finally, as you know, we have, for example, stem. Then we have, for example, a spring here. And then it's going to be coupled to the control valve. This one is the valve. I'm trying to draw all the things in detail. Something just like it. Okay, and this is connected to the actuator. All these things are L-line. So, as you could remember, there is a unit in the positioner which is called as I2P converter. It means that 4 to 20 milliampere is going to be changed to 3.15 PSIG, and with the help of this air control signal, we can have some pressure here too. I can just tell you that if you just set the regulator on 6 bar, I can just tell you that, you know, this line can have the pressure around 0 up to, for example, 5 bar. I said, you know, it's totally approximately this one. I want to tell you that around 1 bar of this pressure approximately is going to be changed to, you know, or is going to be used for creating and generating this signal. And this air signal is going to be controlled, the pressure of this line too. How? Don't worry, I will just talk about this one too. So do not forget the pressure that we have inside of the positioner would be around 6 bar. I said that approximately, at maximum case, we have 5 bar here. So as you can see, the time that the pressure of this line is around 5 bar, it means that, you know, the valve is going to be, you know, shift down and then close the valve. And for sure, the time that the signal reaches to 4 milliampere, the pressure of this line is going to be close to zero. There is no pressure, and in this case, the force of the spring causes that the valve would be open up. So this is the format, or how can I say it, procedure of the working of the positioner here too. One pressure gauge shows the outlet pressure, and another one shows the control, or let me just write air control pressure. I mean 3.15 PSIG. That's it. Sometimes we have some other positioners which are equipped with three pressure gauges. As you can see here, we have just two pressure gauge. And the time that you have two pressure gauge, it means that this positioner is suitable for single acting actuators. The time that you can see three pressure gauges on a positioner, it means that this positioner can be used not only for single acting, but also for double acting too. Because in this case, for sure, they will have two different separate outlet lines, which one of them is going to be connected to, for example, one side of actuator, for example, one side of the piston, and another line is going to be connected to, the second side of the piston.